If x degrees Celsius is equal to x degrees Fahrenheit, find x. This right here is such a famous question because this is the only temperature that the Celsius reading is equal to the Fahrenheit reading. And the answer is just negative 40 because it's so famous. And now let me show you how to do it. Of course, we will need a formula of converting Celsius to Fahrenheit, and let me write that down for you guys. What we do is we take 9 over 5 times, right, this is a little multiplication, times the Celsius, and after that we add 32, and that will give you the temperature in the Fahrenheit measure. I know in the US we use Fahrenheit for temperature, but pretty much anywhere else we use Celsius. And yeah, but anyway though, there's also another version if you want to isolate the C, but since the post use this one, so I'll just stick with this. Now let's see how we can do it. We have x degrees Celsius, so put x for the Celsius right here. So we get 9 over 5 times x. Continue, we have to add 32. And after that, make that equal to, here is the thing. Do not just put down f, right? That's the mistake from the post. Right here, because we also want to have x degrees Fahrenheit. So make sure we also put the x right here for the Fahrenheit. So we make this equal to x, like that. Now you see we have an equation with just x, we will be able to solve x. But we do have an equation with fractions. So now you have two choices. You can just work with fractions, minus 9 over 5x on both sides, and then just get the common denominator, all that. But an easier way to do this is, here we have the denominator 5. Let's just multiply everybody by 5. So let me just take this and then multiply by 5 right here. So what that means is we are going to get the following. We will have 5 times 9 over 5x, and then plus 5 times 32, and that will be equal to 5 times x. Multiply each term by 5, right? Take the 5 and distribute, you know, just distribute, yeah. So you'll multiply the 5 on both sides. Now, we can just work this out. You see the 5 and 5 cancel. So this right here is just 9x. Next, 5 times 32 is 160. And 5x right here, 5 times x, just 5x. Okay, no more fractions. Go ahead, put all the x's on one side. So let me just subtract 9x on both sides. So this term and that term cancel. And let me just write down the x terms right here first. 5x minus 9x is negative 4x. That will be equal to 160. Now, this is negative 4 times x. To get the x by itself, go ahead, divide both sides by negative 4. Cancel. And we will have x by itself, positive 160 divided by negative 4. Positive divided by negative, we get negative. 160 divided by 4, we get negative 40. So this right here is the answer. And if you want to put this back, you will see that we get negative 40 degrees Celsius equals negative 40 degrees Fahrenheit. Super, super, super cool. This is the only temperature that makes this happen. Because remember, if you have 0 degrees Celsius, in fact, you get 32 degrees Fahrenheit, right? The water freezing point. Bye. That's it.